I think we all hope that emission reductions will be achieved, but the lack of success of current attempts at international agreements encourages pessimism. And I honestly would bet, sad though it is, that the annual CO2 emissions are going to rise year by year for at least the next 20 years, and that'll build up a cumulative level close to 500 parts per million by then.
How much do we need to sequester? How much CO2 do we need to dispose of? Globally, we are generating 35 billion tons of CO2 per year. That's 5 tons per person. There's 7 billion people in the world. 7 billion times 5 is 35 billion tons. If we want to sequester CO2 and make a difference, we have to sequester something which is a significant fraction of 35 billion tons per year. So what's a significant fraction of 35 billion? Let's say 20 billion tons. 10 billion tons even, let's make a start. 10 billion tons a year of carbon sequestration. We don't do anything on this planet on that scale. We don't manufacture food on that scale. We don't mine iron ore on that scale. We don't even produce oil, coal or gas on that scale. Iron ore is below a billion tons a year. How are we going to invent a technology from scratch, highly complicated technology, to the tune of 10 billion tons a year?
We should perhaps hope that the other type of geoengineering, the type that involves directly extracting CO2 from the atmosphere, can be made to work in a cost-effective way. Because clearly, if we can undo the experiment we've done on the planet by burning fossil fuels and suck out the CO2 by, as it were, artificial trees that capture it and fix it, then that clearly would be a way to return the climate to the way it was before. But at the moment, my impression is that though these ideas are being discussed, the idea of direct extraction is not yet feasible because it requires a huge amount of energy and a capital investment.
Carbon sequestration, removing CO2 from the atmosphere, will ultimately have to be done. There's more carbon, more CO2 in the atmosphere now than we can live with. We have to remove it sometime in the next few decades, few hundred years. We've got to get back to a lower CO2 environment. If we leave things as they are, we will get global warming, we will get ocean acidification, we will get all sorts of unpleasant consequences. We need to develop those technologies, but those technologies will be developed over a long time scale, tens of decades. We can't wait that long.